During the 40s, the women worked while the men were overseas. Afterwards, the women were expected to go back to being housewives. Television shows of the 1950s, like Leave It to Beaver, portrayed women as housewives and mother, not with career.
Sort of traditional, I guess. You know, they say a woman's place is in the home, and I suppose as long as she's in the home, she might as well be in the kitchen.
Second wave feminists fought for equality among women when it came to issues like sexuality, family, and the workplace. Betty Friedan expressed the unhappiness of housewives in her book The Feminine Speak. The mid-60s and 70s changed life for women. Feminist activists such as Betty Friedan and Gloria Steinem worked for equal rights among women and achieved many victories, including the creation of NOW, the Women's Equal Equity Act, and the Women's Inclusion in Affirmative Action. All of these advancements changed the way women were portrayed on television. In 1975, Wonder Woman got her own TV show. Wonder Woman's creator, Marston, wanted her to be an icon because he believed that the next 100 years will see the beginning of a matriarchy. Eventually, women would take over the rule of the country. Wonder Woman is a symbol of feminism. She is strong and independent. Her accessories are secret weapons and she fights crime. Her bracelets kept her safe from bullets.
Habit of saving your life.
Her tiara worked as a boomerang to help fight crime. Her lasso makes criminals tell the truth.
Got all the underground aqueducts.
What else? It's in the woods with animals. At least there used to be animals.
Animals?
A zoo. Isn't there an old zoo just outside the city? In Maryland.
Oh yeah, but I wouldn't exactly call that wilderness.
Wonder Woman fights crime without the help of a man and is usually seen taking them down.
In your satin tights, fighting for your rights, and your red, white, and blue. Wonder Woman! Wonder Woman!
Now the world is ready for you, and the wonders you can do. Make the hawk and dove, stop a war with love.
She is recognized as the first female superhero and a symbol of femininity. Charlie's Angels were female detectives who worked undercover. Jill was a police graduate who was given a desk job because she was a woman. Become an undercover agent. Become a professional sports diver. Sabrina was also a police graduate who was given a desk job because she was a woman. She becomes a detective. She is considered the smartest angel. Carly is also a detective. She survives kidnapping, chloroform, and gunshot wounds to the head. She is the most sensitive. Women were able to identify with the angels because they weren't superhuman. They were regular women who fought crime. The angel showed that women can't do everything men can, while remaining feminine. She was a former professional tennis player. She was a school teacher by day and a secret agent at night. She was given her bionic powers after almost dying in a parachute crash. She was originally part of the show $6 Million Man, then was killed off, then was given her own show. She made almost double the amount of money as the lead actor from $6 Million Man did.
Look out!
Wonder Woman, Charlie's Angels, and Bionic Woman all aired during the 1970s, after the influence of second wave feminism streamed into media and popular culture. They changed the way women were portrayed on television and paved the way for future shows with strong female characters.
Yeah.